Do you have a mentor? Do you have someone speaking truth into your life? Do you have someone who cares enough about you to tell you the truth and to help you learn and grow? Well, I'm shocked. The data says 60% of leaders don't today. Well, I've begun to try and figure out why that might be the case. Now, that's different from a coach, and I love coaches, and I have coaches in my life, and I have for years, and I'll continue to have coaches. The fundamental difference for me, this is a little oversimplified, a coach and a mentor, they actually can do the same thing. You pay a coach, a mentor does it for free. But you want them both to speak truth into your life. You want both to bring knowledge and experience and a skill set that you're trying to develop. So why don't more people have a mentor? Let's talk about those that don't. I think one is just a lack of intentionality. You know, some don't think it's worth the time, the energy, the effort. Some are too busy. Some are too stressed. I don't want to get into all that. I mean, you've got to decide, is this going to yield an adequate return on your investment of time? Because in my concept, there's no money exchanged if it's mentor versus coach. But let's put all that aside. I would argue that one of the primary reasons that we can push aside here right now is that you can't find anyone. Now, when I find men and women who say they can't find a mentor, I usually follow with a series of questions, but let me just kind of cut to the chase. They're generally looking for too much. They're often looking for somebody that can help them in all areas of their life. It's like, I need somebody to help me with my public speaking skills, my financial acumen. I need somebody to help me with my marriage and my finances and my fitness. It's like, none. I don't know who those people are. I couldn't find those people either. But I encourage folks to find an area where you want to grow and develop and look for someone in that field. Now, the related second issue, when I say they look for too much, they look for the best in the world. Well, most of us don't have access to the people who are best in the world in any field. Don't set the bar too high. All you need to do is find somebody who's a little bit further ahead than you. They've got a little more experience. They've got a little more knowledge. They've got a little more expertise. And so if you'll narrow your search and lower your sights, which I know sounds counterintuitive, but you can learn and grow. And then when you've learned all you can in that relationship, you can get another mentor. I've actually done that. I've done that with paid coaches, where I would pay a coach, hire a coach, pay that coach for a season, and they've got their worldview, and they've got their experience, and they've got their skill sets. And then at some point, this has happened more than once to me, through a mutual agreement, it's time for a new coach. It's time for someone with a different perspective, a different skill set, different experiences. The same is true with mentors. So don't think of it as a long-term, it could be, but don't think of it necessarily as this is a 10-year relationship. Think of this as a relationship that I'm going to learn and grow, and this person's willing to help me. But even that concept is somewhat off-putting or could be daunting to you. It's like, gosh, how would I even approach that? Well, I've had many mentors in my life, and let me let you in on a secret. I've never asked any one of them to be my mentor. I don't know what they think when they hear that term, and I know a lot of people think mentor is like a lifelong commitment. That's not what I'm even asking for. What I generally do is ask someone if I can buy their lunch, or if I can buy their breakfast, or if I can take them out to dinner. And if we hit it off, I say, hey, could we meet again? Hey, maybe could we meet again? Would you be willing to meet with me once a quarter next year? And before you know it, you've got a mentor. So don't let the language be an impediment. A mentor can help you learn and grow. I'm convinced of that.